Welcome back to the Huerto Digital Solutions YouTube channel. In this video tutorial, we'll guide you step by step through the process of creating a new template project using the Business Modeler IDE in Teamcenter. You'll learn how to create a custom object and deploy it effortlessly with the Teamcenter Environment Manager. If you'd like to follow the tutorial at a faster pace, you can adjust the playback speed setting. Just click on the settings below and select playback speed. For a more dynamic experience, I recommend 1.25x or 1.5x. If you find this video helpful or enjoy it, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel. In this way, you don't miss our upcoming Teamcenter tutorials. Thanks for joining us. See you soon.
Hello everyone. In this video, we'll see how to create a new template project, how to deploy it using the Environment Manager. First, we'll need to open the Business Modeler IDE, which from now on we'll call BMIDE. And the first thing that we'll need to do here is to go to File, New Business Modeler IDE Template Project. Then we'll need to set the configuration for this new template project. First, a prefix that needs to be a string of 4 characters, of which one has to be a numeric character. So we'll go with HDS4. Template name, we'll call it simply test. Template display name test, and we'll put in the description, this is a test project. This is the location where the BMIDE will create our project. And we click on next. Here we can see the Teamcenter modules that we'll be using. In this case, Foundation is already selected by default, and we will just select the AWS2. Which is the model for the active workspace. The other modules contain other functionalities, but for the sake of this video and this example, we'll just add this other module. Now, talking about languages, we now can see that here there are a list of languages that which the BMIDE can be initialized with. So this project will be initialized with an English language by default, but we can also add another language depending on which are the requirements of the company or the project that you're doing. In this case, we'll just go on with the English language. And then these other windows are just for additional configurations that in this video we will not see. So we'll go on and click finish. Okay, so now here on the left, we can see all the project that has been created. This is what we call the template project. It includes some items, some things by default, like for example, the business objects. In this case, we will just focus on the item. As you can see, creating a new template project creates also a list of items. And in this case, we're going to create a new item. And we're going to call the item wheel. And as you can see, the name is going to be HDS4 wheel, which is the prefix plus the display name. And then we're going to set a description. This is a wheel for the test project. As we can see here, we can add some custom properties to this item, and that is a child item of the business object item, and you can add custom properties. So we will go on to next, where we can see a new window containing the wheel revision. By default, the VM IDE, every time you create an item, creates also an item revision. So in this case, it has the same name of the item, but it adds the word revision. And then we'll click and go to finish. And you now can see here on the left that HDS4 wheel has been added to the list of items. Now we will go on to perform the deploy. But first, we have to generate the package that we are trying to deploy on the environment manager. We'll click on VM IDE, generate software package. And here we can see the default location where the software package will be generated. I'm going to copy this route because it will be useful for when we will try to do the deploy, because here is the file that we're going to take to give to the environment manager to add the new features. We'll go on to finish, and then we'll save the changes that we just did to the template project and finish the packaging. With this, the software package is generated, and we'll now go on with the deployment. The deployment is started clicking on the environment manager. Go and choose the configuration manager option. And perform maintenance on an existing configuration. Let us note that we are using a configuration that has been already set up. Here we choose my configuration one. And here there is a list of options that we could choose. In this case, we're choosing the option add or remove features, because it's the first time that we're adding these features of this new template project. After we have created this project and done the first deploy, we'll always use the option update database full model, because it has already been deployed and you just have to modify these features. But in this case, we're going with the first option. So now we're going to next, and here are the features installed in the current configuration, and we are trying to install the new features of the template project. So we'll click on browse and choose the new file that we have just generated, that is going to be in this route, DPLM teachroot BMIDE workspace. So we'll go to this DPLM teachroot BMIDE workspace HDS4 test and output. Here is the generated package, and we'll choose packaging full update, and this is the software package that we generated from the VM IDE. As you can see, it's generated at the hour 18:46. We'll choose these temp contributions, and this is the file. We select this file. It's going to appear under extensions, and we're going to check it. We'll click next, and here there's going to be a message that tells us that all Teamcenter services must be stopped to perform the deploy. How can we see that? We'll go into services, and we can see that all Teamcenter services are running. So we'll need to stop them. So now that I have stopped all the services, there is just the Teamcenter FSC service, which is important to keep on running because it's useful for the deployment. We'll click OK and insert the password for the InfoDBA user. And now we could see that the HDS4 test template XML is going to be applied to the database. We'll click on next and start the deploy. The deployment has finished, so we'll go on to test if effectively the new feature has been included to the Teamcenter. So we'll click on the Teamcenter app and it's going to require me to log in. And now we're going to go to File, New Item, where we are going to choose the wheel item that we just created. Assign this item. Let's say this is a wheel created for the example. Its name is going to be my wheel one and next. These other windows are just additional configurations that in this case we're not going to see. So we'll click on finish. Here you can see that the new item has been created, 0019 my wheel. It's also created the revision for this new item that we just created. So, thank you for watching. I hope you like it. Goodbye.